Officials of the Minister of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities, led by the Minister Tom Butime and State Minister Martin Mogara, appeared before Parliament's Committee on Trade and Tourism to explain the budget framework paper of the entity. The ministers had no kind words with the Finance Ministry, which cut their budget from 195 billion shillings in the current financial year to 89.2 billion shillings for the financial year 2023-2024, which is less than half of the current budget.
That at one point maybe you're milking a cow without feeding it, but now it would be strangling the real cow now, so it would be much more dangerous. But I want to thank the committee members for the support, and I know with your support we shall still get through this.
That finance did not concentrate well when it came to this particular sector. Either it is a computer error or something like that, because the figures don't balance in any way. Because if you are going to allow, if you are going to send home rangers who will become poachers, isn't it? Then it means that the ministry did not, I think, put enough understanding and work on the figures properly.
Has recruited over rangers, over 800. So how are we going to pay these rangers if the budget has been cut? We are supposed to be marketing destination Uganda. We have been hit by the worst publicity from COVID to Ebola. Most of the tourism sites had cancellations during Christmas. So now how are we going to market destination Uganda if we don't have the money?
The permanent secretary, Doreen Katusime, explained that 89.2 billion shillings budget does not consider the wage-related costs of the 3,450 staff of subvention agencies of Uganda Wildlife Authority, Uganda Wildlife Education Center, Uganda Hotel and Tourism Training Institute, and Uganda Wildlife Research and Training Institute, that amounts to 65 billion shillings, as well as other fixed costs, about 50 billion shillings in these institutions.
You, in your remarks, already mentioned the 850 rangers that are being added to the UWA staff. So we have over 3,450 staff in the sector from the ministry and its agencies. The wage alone requires more than 65 billion. So this is going to be one of the major impacts, that we will not be able to pay wage. Now with these cuts, the budget for Uganda Tourism Board has reduced from 26 billion to 4 billion, and this is impractical and completely contradicts the government's focus on promoting and marketing the country's tourism offerings.
The executive director of Uganda Wildlife Authority, Sam Mwanda, informed the committee that they have a wage bill of 56 billion shillings after recruiting 860 rangers recently, but they have been allocated only 21.3 billion. He says rangers are likely to turn into poachers if they send them home over lack of salary.
Not be able to do any work, and we are likely to release a lot more poachers from our own staff that we might have to lay off because we have no salary for them.
Uganda Tourism Board budget has reduced from 26.45 billion shillings to 4.3 billion shillings, which according to the ministry is going to frustrate positive strides in promoting and marketing the country's tourism potential that fetches Uganda more foreign exchange.
If only more can be given to the sector, then we should be able to achieve a lot more. Chair, for emphasis is really about the brand rollout. I think this points out to something that we have done very well as a sector. We rebranded our destination as Explore Uganda, the Pearl of Africa, to have the endorsement from CNN, you know, for us to be among the 23 destinations that they are selling to the world to focus on this year. It's not a mean achievement. 6 international tourism film awards for Uganda. That's not a mean achievement. None of our competitors within the region has made that achievement. So if we do not build on this, then we will actually be going backwards.
The Uganda Wildlife Education Center's budget has been trimmed from 9.5 billion shillings in the current financial year to 1.9 billion shillings in 2023-2024. The agency is concerned that it will not be able to meet the cost of feeding animals at Entebbe Zoo, which stands at 2.5 billion shillings annually.
Cost for feeding the animals is 2.5 billion. So if with one...
That is per year.
2.5 billion. So and we've been allocated 1.9 billion in the next financial year. And with the increasing prices of food and other commodities, it's going very difficult to operate efficiently.
In the financial year, 2.9 billion.
2.5 billion.
And also your salaries cost?
3.7 billion.
So it means you cannot pay salaries and you cannot feed animals.
Yes.
So these are the fixed costs we wanted you to come with to the committee to justify.
Committee members joined the ministry officials to lament on the budget cuts and vowed to press the Minister of Finance until the tourism budget is reinstated.
For tourism development program is now. If we don't, then the notion that we all know that tourism is a game changer and therefore identified as a national priority by NDP3 will just remain on paper.
Is actually there. It is now up to us as members of parliament of this committee to make sure we help the parliament and the Minister of Finance realize that this sector actually needs to be funded.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.